For the final time, we bring you to Krasnoyarsk's Biathlon Academy. It is the last event on this calendar, which has produced so much excitement. The last day of competition, and it's the mass start for men. The women were earlier today. It's the men over 15 kilometers, as it was for the women. This is the last chance for those who think they might not have performed at their best. They have this opportunity to redeem themselves. 6 degrees minus. Again, southwesterly breeze, which didn't seem to affect the women all that much this morning in the shooting. And we'll see what it does to the men this afternoon. It's an interesting lineup, and we'll see that very shortly. The Russians, of course, have dominated, but some of those who have won medals are not competing today. But among those who is Dmitry Ivanov, with gold in the pursuit and a silver in the sprint. The Russians are spread throughout the competition today, unlike the women, where the six leading athletes were all Russians, and they led their way the way from the start, from the gun. Interesting to see Kryukov, Belarus, back after injury. The starter is about to fire the first shot of this event. The men's mass start is underway. The final event in Krasnoyarsk, the biathlon of the 2019 Winter Universiade. The Russians have dominated. Others have tried. They've all failed to break this domination. But maybe today, the likes of Dmitry Ivanov and Alexander Dedukin might just be put under pressure by some of the others in this event. That was Ivanov on the inside, wearing number one. He'll be prominent throughout. Cote Purnell was superb yesterday for the French single mixed relay team. And he will be hovering somewhere. Out on the right there was Varabai, number three. In the background, we could just see Opsahl of Norway. The Norwegians haven't really fired, but watch on the left there, number four, Espen Uldal. He's shown that he's as good as the rest on the skis. And if he can get his shooting under control, then maybe he will be in with a chance. In the center of the screen there, Varabai of Belarus. And on the outside, and we'll see a lot of him, I'm sure, Matthias Janik of Poland, number six. Nothing separating them. The first break will come, no doubt, when they lie down on the ground and sight the five targets and start pulling the trigger. And 15 of them within spitting distance of each other. Tighter race early on than we saw for the women. The big screen has indicated to the fans in the stadium that the athletes are upon them. They're entering the shooting range for the first time. Penalty loop for any misses, of course. Shooting prone, and then standing. First of four shoots, they're in the lanes corresponding to their bib number. Wow, let's look at the white. Anyone go through without a blemish? Still waiting for Petrov. He's got three very quickly. Petrov, still got one to shoot, and goes. So he's shooting well. but there were a few with misses. Panchets through, and Tola also clean. Rugal and Upshal. The two of them just striding along together. Rugal, Upshal from Norway, both of them. Farabai. That's Vadabai coming through the 3.8. Uldal, Ivanov, 5 seconds down. So no change there. Not at all in any state of panic. Dedukin, who won the gold medal in the single mixed relay yesterday. 3.8. Tola, Panchets of Poland, Tomshin. Ryukov, two Russians there, numbers 13 and 27. Uldal looking around to see who's doing what. You'll notice that Varabai is right with him. And Ivanov. This is where Uldal really needs to be composed and relaxed. Start to think about the time that he's put on the range since he got here. Almost a couple of days ago in the pursuit, he just looked to be, well, he wanted to fire quickly, but he wasn't being accurate. So what can he do today? Espen Uldal of Norway. He attends inland Norway's University of Applied Sciences. He started in everything here, as have most of the athletes, in fact. The three leaders approaching the halfway stage of this men's mass start, the final event in the biathlon at the Universiade in Krasnoyarsk, Siberia. They come to their second prone shoot, led in by number four, Espen Uldal of Norway. And behind him, Maxim Varabay of Belarus, Dmitry Ivanov of the Russian Federation. They are down, controlling their breathing. Uldal, correct with one, correct with two, three. Ivanov misses. Uldal four. Uldal five. That's outstanding for the young Norwegian through the second shooting range. So he's clear after two shoots. So Uldal. Now we'll see what the margin is. As those who have missed, and Petrov going all to pieces there. What the margin is for Uldal. And how will he respond to this pressure? He sails away on the left-hand side, up past the stand. The crowd will roar as his nearest rivals go through the dreaded penalty loop. Varabai at 26 seconds down. Uldal. Mind must be clear at the 6.8 kilometer mark. Let's see what his advantage might be over the chasing Varabai of Belarus. It was 26 seconds coming out of the penalty loop for this man. Oh, so Varabai has made his intentions clear. He's going to chase hard. Upshal at 28 seconds. Tola, 34. First of the Russians coming through, the likes of Tomshin. Dukin, number five. The relaxing glide and slide, which enables the athletes to bring their breathing under control just a little and get their minds clear as they enter the shooting arena with a few flurries of snow. The wind has not increased in intensity, but the noise has. Shooting coach for Norway has seen Uldal below his best too often here. He's done this very well. He's been slowly down that stretch. He's got the time. Gets his breathing under control very quickly, but misses. Fires quickly. 1 miss, that's all, but very quickly. And Vannebye is just unslinging his rifle. Well, Uldal might be out of the penalty area before Vannebye has shot. Oh, but he's very accurate. Oh, a little punch to say yes, that's good. And here the two of them will meet. Uldal coming out of the penalty zone. Vannebye has just put his gloves properly on and pulled down his goggles, and they are now together. 0.3 of a second separates them. What will happen to the other places? Oh, two of them slinging their rifles over their shoulders at the same time. Here we come, 9.8. So Vannebye and Uldal were together. Thompson, Opshal, Tola also together. So it's two out in front, three behind, five looking for one of those three medals. At the 10.4 kilometre stage of this 15 kilometre race, Vannebye of Belarus and Uldal of Norway, they are the two who have clear air behind them. Then the chasers. Amongst them, Thompson of Russia, Opshal, Norway, and Tola of the Czech Republic, number seven. Just going past one of the effects microphones here, not just picking up the sound of ski on snow, but oh, great, another great climb by the Belarusian. Thompson, third place, coming up to the 10.8. This is another split. We'll get the time on them. Time, it's nearly 1 minute. Thompson at 54 seconds down. Then the next two, Tola and Opsal. Flurries of snow continue in the stadium area, where they will stand in a moment to shoot for the last time. into the shooting range for the fourth and final time. Two leaders in this final event. And Uldal, as usual, quickly into it. One penalty. Farabai will not know that. He's just concentrating on his own. He needs to nail this to make sure he doesn't. Farabai makes a miss. And so Uldal, already into the penalty lap, will come out of it with possibly a 20-second advantage. And it will be Farabai's skiing strength and willpower and determination that will see us determine the winner here. Out of his penalty lap goes the Norwegian. So Vaklavic from the Czech Republic is all of a sudden the new third place getter. Tomshin is 13 seconds down and fourth, 24-year-old Maxim Farabai, in his endeavour to chase down 22-year-old Espen Uldal of Norway. The gap was 30 seconds. For a man whose shooting had been disappointing throughout the biathlon at the Winter Universiade, it is going to be his shooting which proves the advantage, proves beneficial to him, the big decisive factor in this race. The Norwegians will be absolute, they have loved this sport. We all know how much biathlon means to the Norwegian winter sports fans, and this will be a real present, a party piece for this Norwegian team and also for the Czech Republic, for Adam Vaklavic, striving to shut out the Russian Federation. Just to bring you back to the fact that Poroshnev and Latyapov are not in this, but we do have the gold medalist in the pursuit and the silver in the sprint, Dmitry Ivanov. He's back in fifth place after some poor shooting, four misses, four penalties. At 13.8, Uldal of Norway is a comfortable leader. As Tomshin of Russia going through. Oh, he's looking comfortable. He's looking confident. The smoothness is there as he scorches past Straba of Slovakia. And he does again take that opportunity just to look to his left and see that there is no diminishing of his lead. Smoothly now, no pressure. Tuck it up and suck it up. Suck up this wonderful reception that you're going to get now. Espen Uldal, up the rise he comes, in front of the stadium to a tremendous roar. No matter how tired he is, he cannot help but grin. The winner of the men's mass start, the final event, Espen Uldal of Norway, fulfilling the promise that he showed earlier. With practically a flawless performance, the best shooter of the day, Maxim Farabai of Belarus. One more penalty was costly for him. but it's a silver medal. And in third place, Adam Vaklavich of the Czech Republic. Fabulous shooting and skillful skiing gives Norway's Espen Uldal the gold medal from Varabai and Vaklavich, Belarus and the Czech Republic, respectively.
We're glad to greet you at the awarding ceremony of the 29th Winter University in Krasnoyarsk 2019 for the biathlon mass start, man.
Well, it's fitting that there's a little bit of snow falling now. There's been none throughout the event. The temperatures have been unusually warm. But now we do have a farewell flurry of snow.
Third place and bronze medalist representing Czech Republic, Adam Vaklavich.
Clearly delighted. Not really in the thoughts of many as a medal contender, but he did what he needed to. And the bronze medal goes to the Czech Republic, Adam Vaklavich.
Second place and silver medalist representing Belarus, Maxim Varabey.
He'll be ruining one shot. That really was the difference between the silver and the gold. The silver medalist, Maxim Varabey of Belarus.
Золотой призер зимней универсиады 2019.
The gold medalist of the 29th Winter University at Krasnoyarsk 2019, representing Norway, Espen Uldal.
Hey, he skied sensationally, but he shot even better. Just two penalties, the gold medal, Espen Uldal of Norway.
And this is a feeling that we now give to all gold medalists from this year.
Thank you.
The biathlon has concluded at the 2019 Winter Universiade. The Russians dominated, 8 gold, 7 silver and 6 bronze. Norway 1 gold. The Czech Republic 1 silver, 1 bronze. Belarus 1 silver. France 2 bronze. And so it's farewell from Krasnoyarsk and a big thank you for watching.